This topic, ocean currents and their circulation.
The regular movements in the ocean are of two types, horizontal direction, ocean currents, and vertical direction, the rising of water pressure and sinking
of the soil. Okay, read in your heart, you also. After 5 minutes, I will ask that what you have understood from this.
Ocean currents can be on two, in two directions also. Like I have seen in some. I have heard like sailors used to find that where the water was going in direction.
Yes, the ocean like, currents are
both the water, like the two sides of water are going in other directions.
See, these ocean currents are very much important. If you will study about the importance of these ocean currents, they facilitate us very much in terms of navigation, in terms of fishing. These ocean currents, and you know, if we will especially talk about the cold currents and the warm current, when these two currents mixed, it will give you best area or site for fishing. Now the technology is very much advanced. Earlier people used to adopt the direction of this flow only, and they are moving from one place to another, and because of this direction only they were knowing about different places also, because you know, when these currents are flowing, they are striking to some land area also. That is why. Okay, stop. So, share your points, whatever you have understood from the para. Whatever, one or two line, whatever. Yes, Siddha, you tell first.
And this ocean water movement is of two types. One is horizontal, which is caused by the wind, and one is vertical, which is caused by the tide.
Okay, fine. Aksa, apart from this, up. See, this density depends upon temperature or not? There is a relationship between density or temperature?
Yes.
Very much. This process you have to remember. Okay, fine. Ilma?
The movement of currents depends upon density and
density also, temperature and salinity. Very much important. The amount of the amount of salt present in the water. Okay, fine. Good. See, if you will talk about majorly ocean currents, tides we will discuss later on. Okay. So, if you will look at the basic definition of this ocean current. See, ocean current is the flow of mass water in a definite direction. Mass flow of water, particular direction should be there. Okay, this is a layman definition of ocean current. Okay, and if we will talk about the movements of ocean current, so we can divide these ocean currents into two types. and these are horizontal currents, horizontal movement and vertical movement. If we will talk about the horizontal movement, so it will be further divided into and if we will talk about this vertical movement, sinking of what is there? And means sinking and rising of the water. This process you can see or you can correlate this topic with this tide. Understanding something? Tide, in the process of tide, you will see sometime water sink and sometime water rise up, and it depends upon the gravitational force of majorly. Okay, so here you can see. Okay, understood? And apart from this, you have to remember one more thing. Surface water flow occurring and deep water flow. If we will look at the picture here, this is a water body. I'm not that much good at drawing. Okay, so if you will look at, this is the surface of the water body, okay, and this is the bottom part, you can say ocean bed or sea bed, okay, according to the ocean or sea, and here you can say surface. So there are two movements also. See, here water moves on the surface of the water, and here also water moves inside the ocean also, and here also, and it can be sometime in the opposite direction also. See, here the movement of water is very fast as compared to this one. Okay, so here just try to understand this term, surface and the deep water flow. This process inshallah I will explain with the help of example. Okay, now this ocean currents depends upon the density, majorly I am talking about temperature and salinity. Okay, if we will talk about, this is related to your science, you know this thing, this is very much important. See, if we will talk about this density, can anybody tell, if we will take the example of equatorial region, the region located near to the equator, okay, so can anybody tell, near the equatorial region, density will be high or low? Density will be high or low? High or low?
High, like density would decrease.
Heat will be more.
Heat will be more, density
would
decrease.
Low density. Okay, so this is also, and temperature has also played an important role. See, in terms of water, temperature, why temperature is very much important? See, if you will look at the world map, here torrid zone, here torrid zone, so what happened? Here, if water bodies are there, temperature will rise, water will move upward, okay? Upward, and it will move to polar areas or northern part because water become light. And if we will talk about the north polar, so here more coldness is there. So sometimes what happened? When wind direction is there, when wind direction is there, so it moves that time only, and this here water become heavier also because of the salinity also. So it subsided and it will move like this. So here temperature also play an important role in this ocean current. Salinity, want to explain or you can understand? This is very easy. Salinity is also very much important. Yes, and apart from this, do you feel that wind is important? Like you can take the example of a bucket. In that bucket water is there. If we will give what? Some force, and we can say that if we will give some pressure, so it will create some disturbance. It will create some kind of disturbance. And like we will do, it will move like this because we are creating force from the mouth and air is coming. Yes, air is coming from our mouth, okay? And that air leads to push the water in that direction. Okay, like I'm having some water. So it will go like this. So, winds, especially prevailing winds, permanent winds, like trade winds, anti-trade winds called westerlies also. So these permanent winds are having the special characteristics. What kind of special characteristics? These permanent winds having a definite direction. What is definite direction? And they flow throughout the air. So definitely it impacts the direction or it impacts the ocean currents.
Are you talking about horizontal or vertical?
Which one?
Here.
Here?
This one. When you were explaining these three topics, density, temperature, salinity. You were talking about horizontal movement or vertical?
Here I am talking about this one. Horizontal in terms of warm currents and the cold currents. Okay? This vertical movement we will talk in relation to the tides. Okay? Till here everything is clear? In your book, one term is there, that is heat balance or heat budget. Any idea about this? This is also very much important if we will talk about the ocean current. This ocean current helps to maintain the heat balance. What is this? Heat balance. Heat balance or heat budget. This is very much important.
It is regulating heat from lower to higher altitude.
Very good. Explain more about it. If we will focus on the heat zone of the earth, like torrid zone, hottest part. So what happened? Air will rise up or water will go also. So what will happen? It transfer heat and energy and whatever the things. It also transfer the temperature and the heat with the water. So if from the equatorial region to the polar region, it is the transfer of temperature, another thing also. So you can say that it transferred the heat also from one place to another and it maintained the heat balance of the earth. Understood? Okay. Now take out one page. Take out one page. Take out one page, write your name. Whatever we have discussed in today's class with the reference to this chapter, tide and ocean currents, share your things on the paper. It should be in a proper way. You can share in bullet points, summary type, whatever you have understood, you can write. I think 5 to 6 minutes are there. 5 minutes. Just I just want to see that how much you have understood. Recall all the things. And please try to read the other causes of the ocean currents, like I have explained winds, salinity, and other factors I have discussed. Rest of the factors, try to read it. And if you feel any confusion, so you can ask in the next class.